Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Or if you're new, welcome. Today I'm going to be teaching you how to make a GFX on Blender 2.9. I got a comment on one of my other videos asking me to do a tutorial on this, so here it is. So, first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to open Roblox Studio. And if you don't have this, I'll link it in my description. Once it opens, click on Base Plate. And now what you're going to do is you're going to go up to here, and where it says plugins, you're going to get the load character plugin. And if you don't already have this, just go into this little arrow right here and go down to plugins. Then you can just search up load character. And then there is one that costs 25 Robux, but there should be a free one too. So just click on that and then download it. Now that your character plugin should be loaded in, you're just gonna click on that and get whatever character you want. So I'm gonna get mine. So you're just gonna type in, you know, your username. So now that I have mine right here, I'm gonna click Spawn R6. Make sure you click Spawn R6 because that's important so the texture in Blender won't be like weird and morphed and stuff. So, we have our character. I'm gonna right click on the name over here. And then I'm gonna export selection. And then you can just save it to wherever you like. I usually like saving it to my downloads because I'm on Mac. So I'm just gonna name that me, and then I'm gonna save. I'll just repeat that. Okay, next, what we're gonna do is we're gonna want to get our model. You don't have to get a room model if you don't want, because that is a little bit advanced, so I'm just gonna go ahead and get a model. So go back into models over here, and then you can just search up whatever type of models you want. I usually go into this little like filter thing right here, and then I search up a username, and Fairy Jewel models are really cute, so I'm just gonna search up her username and apply that. Okay, so now that I found a model that I like, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm gonna right click over here, export selection, and then I'm just gonna name it Halloween model. And then I'm gonna save. It might take a little depending on like how many extra items your model has and all that. In Blender, we're going to need our rig. So this tutorial is with rig. So I'm gonna show you how to get the rig. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to Google, and then you're just gonna search up. I'll have the link in the description, but I'm just gonna search it like that, and then I have this. So when you click on the link, you're gonna be sent to here. Just click download. And then, you should have it right down there. Okay, so what we're gonna do to open the rig is we're gonna click File, Open. And then we're just gonna get, I have a couple rigs here, but you can just get whatever rig you downloaded. So when you open it up, it should look like this. And to move around in Blender, you do use the regular WASD keys, but you do need to press shift and then that little like squiggly line on your keyboard. I don't know what it's called, but it's like right below the escape button. So shift and that, and then WASD, and you can just move around. And to go faster, you just hold shift. So that's how you move around. But next, what you're gonna do after you get your rig is you're gonna click on the head and press X and then delete. So how you delete is you just press X. So I'm just gonna go ahead and delete all of the things on the head. Okay, so now what we have is this like pinkish purplish body, and we want it to have our texture, obviously. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna click like wherever on the rig, and then if you see this little button up here, you click that, and then shader editor right here. Now we're gonna have a bunch of these little things. What you're gonna do is you're gonna wanna zoom in, and you're gonna have these two orange ones. Go to the bottom orange one. Just like that. I'm gonna open it a little bit so you can see better. And then you're gonna click this folder. And then you can just, you know, open your texture. So there's my texture. And now it's like my body. So, next we need our head. So go into File, Import, Wavefront OBJ. And then where it says geometry, we're gonna wanna press split by group. This is important because otherwise when you import it, it'll all be grouped into the same thing and you won't be able to take your head off. So make sure to press split by group. And then I'm just going to find my thing. So there is my thing, whatever, avatar. So yeah, you just press the red arrow to move it aside, and then I'm gonna move over here, and then I'm going to delete my other body parts, and now I have this. So if you don't want your extra accessories, just delete that if you only want like the head and the hair. But I do like this bag, so I'm just going to click all of this, and to select more than one thing, you have to hold shift while you're selecting. Otherwise it would just be like that and you'd just be clicking like one thing at a time. So make sure to hold shift when you are, you know, clicking on your things. And now we want to move this like arrows and stuff up to our head. So what we're going to do that is we're going to set the origin. So go into Edit, Menu, Search, Set Origin, and then you're going to see all these. Make sure to do origin to geometry. That'll make it so that this origin is at the head or whatever we clicked on, so that you can move it easy, like more easily. Okay, so I'm just gonna move this and then press rotate to turn it around. Now I'm just gonna align it how I want it to be. Okay, so now that we have our entire avatar, what we're gonna do next is we're going to start posing. So what you're gonna do to pose is you're gonna see down here, it might be in object mode. So what you're gonna do to make it able to like pose with these little lines and stuff that are highlighted in orange is you're gonna click there and then click pose mode. Now they look all different colors, so you're gonna press rotate, and then if you press that one, you can basically just rotate the arm however you'd like, and you can even bend the limbs, see? Yeah, that's basically what we're gonna do now, and you can do that with any of the body parts. And if you want to see how I'm going to pose it and you just want to do that too, just slow down the video. Okay, so now that I'm back and I like how my rig is posed, I'm just going to import the model. So before we do that, I just want to say you should be going into File and then just save, because Blender does sometimes crash and it's really annoying. So yeah, you should make sure you do that. So now we're just going to go into File, import boyfriend OBJ and make sure it's split by group. And then I'm just going to look for my model. I named it Halloween model, so there it is. And then I'm just going to import it. And again, it might take a little. It's been imported. It's obviously clipping really badly. So now we're just going to move the avatar to wherever we want it to be. So make sure you're on object mode and then click on all those little lines. And then you can just go ahead and click all the parts of your head. And it should do the trick. If not, then just click the rest of the body parts because, see, it works. Okay, now I'm just going to move it onto the bench. Okay, so now that I like how it looks, I'm going to just go ahead and set all of the settings. So first, what we're going to do is we're going to go into this button right here, and where it says render, I'm going to do 160, and then where it says denoising, I'm just gonna click that. So NLM is kind of a better render setting. It just takes a little longer. So you can just set it to whatever you like better. And then I'm gonna go into light paths and go into transparency and turn that all the way down. And then I'm gonna go into this button right under it, click that. And where it says FFM, like whatever, this part, I'm gonna click that and make it PNG RGBA. And then I'm going to now put my camera down. So over here, go into add camera, and then you can press this button to go in and out of your camera view. And to move your camera, you can just move around the same way you move around normally in Blender, and you can just set your camera however you'd like it. But I usually do 1200 by 1200 because that's the normal Instagram size. So I'm gonna just set that like that. And then there we go. I like how that looks. Okay, so now we're gonna do our lighting. You can always do like add and then put your light down, but I'm gonna be teaching you how to do HDRI Haven lighting. So basically HDRIs are like environment textures. So I'm just gonna search up HDRI Haven, and I'm gonna have the link in the description as well. And then you just can find anyone you like. I like this one, so I'm gonna click on that. And then download the one that says 4K. So click on that, and then there it goes. It's downloaded. So we're gonna go into this little like earth button thing, and we're gonna press use nodes. And then this yellow button next to color, we're gonna press that, and then go to environment texture. Then we're gonna press open, and you're just gonna find your texture. So I like this one, so I'm gonna click on that. And then I'm also gonna save, just to make sure. And now, if I go into rendered mode, I can see that it's really nicely lit. I like how everything looks. And yeah, that's it. So to render, you go up to this button right here, render, and then just press render image. After it's done rendering, it's finally finished and complete. So to save, go to image, save as, and then save it to wherever you like it, to wherever you'd like it to be. So I'm going to save it to my GFX folder, and I'm just gonna name it tutorial. Tutorial, and there we go. Now it's saved, and that's basically how you make a GFX on Blender 2.9. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed, please give this video a big thumbs up. And if this helped you, or if you have any questions, let me know in the comments down below. Also, subscribe if you want to see more content like this from me. Anyways, bye!